Short answer is due to a number of coincidences and attempts at trade with the Inuits. It is important to note that there is a common idea that Greenland was discovered and colonized 1,000 years ago. This is correct, but has only very little to do with Greenland being part of the Danish realm today. It was not Danes who discovered nor colonized Greenland originally. It was the Norwegians, and these colonies died out in the 1400s. What did happen was that Denmark and Norway became a double monarchy and thus controlled by the same monarch residing in Copenhagen in Denmark. Although contact with the Greenlandic Norse colonies had been lost, the memory remained. In 1721, the Norwegian preacher Hans Ihle arrived at what is today Nuuk, the capital of Greenland. Through 10 years, he had tried to convince the king to send him to Greenland to convert the long-lost settlers from Catholicism to Protestantism. He did not find the settlers, as they had been gone for centuries. He only found the local Inuit. He did establish a missionary station, which would be the foundation of the Danish-Norwegian colonies on the west coast of Greenland. Hans Ihle did not arrive in unknown territory, however. The Greenlandic west coast had long been visited by whalers from other Western European countries, like the Dutch. So the expedition of Hans Ihle was not a novelty to the Inuit. Denmark-Norway did try to establish a whaling business, but failed in competition with the more experienced whalers of Europe. The station in Nuuk was maintained, but not given much interest from the government. Most often the government tried to license the rights to conduct Greenlandic trade to private operators, but they failed to make any real profit, so the rights continually returned to the crown. Within the administration of Denmark-Norway, the Greenlandic colonies were subject to Norway, like Iceland and the Faroe Islands. As the whaling business had failed, the Greenlandic colonies mainly conducted fur trade with the local Inuit population, thus being more stationary than the whalers. It is important to note that these colonies were merely trading stations and only along a small part of the west coast around Nuuk, and no other powers recognized any claim by Denmark-Norway over the island. It was not until the Congress of Vienna in 1815 that any recognition was given by other countries. Denmark-Norway had been an ally of Napoleon and France, thus the king had to give up the crown of Norway, which was given to the king of Sweden, creating the double monarchy of Sweden-Norway. The Norwegian colonies remained under the crown of Denmark, however, most likely due to disinterest on the part of the Swedish king. This, however, meant that recognition was given to the Danish claim to the Faroe Islands, Iceland and Greenland. The recognition was only of the colonies on the west coast, not of the entire island, as this had not yet been mapped. Denmark thus lost its way to its claim on the largest island in the world. Due to the failure of licensing the trade on Greenland to private contractors, the government established the Royal Greenland Company in 1776 with a monopoly on trade with the colonies in Greenland. This monopoly only was on the government colonies, but by the end was for the entire island. The monopoly lasted until 1950. All large companies in Greenland today have their origin in the Royal Greenland Company. The company came to dominate the west coast of Greenland and functioned as its government. It did not have the strength to control the sea near the west coast, however, so the whalers and fishing vessels of other countries still came to the waters. It did, however, monopolize fur trade with the Inuit. And so it remained until around 1900. The company only slightly extended its colonies along the west coast, but did not go to Thule or the east coast. Perryland at the very top of Greenland was mapped by the American explorer Robert Perry, and the east coast was visited by Norwegian fur hunters. That the Danish claim was extended is in large part due to the explorer Knud Rasmussen, who established the Thule colony as his private trading station to finance his expeditions. He continued to map the entire Greenlandic coast and even traveled across Canada to Alaska. These expeditions lent strength to the Danish claim to all of Greenland. The Thule colony was bought by the Danish state in 1937. Denmark established colonies in eastern Greenland after 1900 to strengthen the claim to the island. Norway disputed the claim to East Greenland, but was ruled against at an international court, which finally established the Danish claim to the entire island in 1933. The Danish claim was undoubtedly strengthened by an agreement with the United States in 1917, where the US acknowledged the Danish claim to Greenland as part of the treaty that signed over the Danish Virgin Islands to the US. Thus, Denmark came to possess the largest island in the world. In 1953, Greenland became a municipality in Denmark, which lasted until 1979, when Greenland was granted internal autonomy and the remaining parts of the Royal Greenland Company was transferred to the Greenlandic government. Autonomy was increased in 2009 in a treaty which also granted Greenland the future option of independence. But for now, Greenland remains part of the Danish realm.